for this motor, you need to follow with a long nose, and the T-51 is the best choice for that.
Now here's one. I was talking to Eric Myers, our resident genius, and we were looking at it. And I'm thinking, how in the world are you going to cool an inline four without liquid or something like that? And Eric was coming out of the first cylinder is a little bit right at lean, richer on down the line. So you're going to fuel the engine. Now when this lands, you need to look at it. The motor mount is all structural carbon fiber and it's workable. Vinny, you can sell CDs of that motor sound.
Yes. I'm going to feel a little bit better. I'm going up and take the full size, and I think every motor that I saw all those friends from here coming over to have a look at that motor, and we were asked, when do you run it? We just came right here.
How many horsepower is that?
I don't know exactly.
Wow.
Enough.
That's a lot. What do you guys think of the motor? I mean, just the motor alone, something like that, just a showstopper. But you throw in the big, beautiful P-51, you throw in the motor mount with all the steel stuff, that is incredible. I'm assuming we have power boxes in this airplane too, yeah?
Well, sure.
I don't think anyone should leave the ground without that. No.
For landing, you see they flow the model without the cooling, the cowling, sorry, and but they had some problems yesterday and they weren't in the motor. They
I will tell you, if I had a motor like that, there would never be a cowling on that airplane, ever.
Yes.
Yeah.